Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Welcome, children, to another story. Today's story is about the Black Stone. Another major event in the history of Mecca was the reconstruction of the Kaaba. Now, how did this happen? Let's find out. The Kaaba had always stood upright, gracefully, and outstandingly. With Ibrahim alayhi salam's dua's acceptance, the whole city had been blessed. With Qusay's invitation, many people had made houses close to the Kaaba. So it happens that once, accidentally, the Kaaba cloth caught fire and the Kaaba walls were weakened badly by the fire. Then after a few years, the land around the Kaaba got flooded. This time, the water level rose and affected the strength of the Kaaba walls. They started to break. There was a great danger of Kaaba collapsing that scared everyone. They wanted to repair it, but bringing it down and then rebuilding it would be the right decision. However, the Quraysh feared to be punished by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for bringing it down. The most senior man in Mecca named Walid bin Mughira was consulted. He was courageous enough to come forward and take the first step of bringing it down, announcing that Allah will not destroy reformers. Moving with this niyyah in his heart and words as such, he was hopeful. People stood back and observed, lest anything should happen to him from Allah. Everyone knew about what had happened to Abraha's army, but all seemed good. The day went by. Walid bin Mughira was all right. So they were all relieved, and then they joined in to help him. Coincidentally, around the same time, a ship carrying excellent quality construction material and skilled labor was on its way to Yemen for a project. The ship survived a close shipwreck and barely made it to the Arabian shore. The owners could not carry the heavy material back, so they wanted to sell this material to anyone interested. As soon as the Meccans found out about this, they decided to purchase it for building the Kaaba. They were careful to use all clean incomes coming from clean ways of earnings, and they set off to pay the Roman skillful masons to do so. The work started. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills, so it happens. The Kaaba was going to be rebuilt. Everyone was relieved. The honorable work was on way, and this brought happiness to everyone. Since the funds were less, a smaller Kaaba was made. Instead of a previous rectangle shape, a square was constructed, hoping maybe in future it could be extended. However, that was not necessary. All was going well. But as the builders built the walls almost halfway up, now the black stone called Al-Hajr al-Aswad was to be placed. Every tribe thought this was an honorable thing to do, and their chief should do it. If you can recall, Qusay's sons were responsible for carrying out the Kaaba caretaking tasks and the pilgrim tasks. So now their descendants questioned as to who should do it from amongst them. The work stopped. Oops, a crisis was coming up. Anger was rising and it was feared that a war could break out. That would have been a disaster. Imagine the scene, Kaaba halfway down and the people ready to kill each other in the haram. That was scary. There was no hope of a sensible solution. Alhamdulillah, a respected man named Abu Umayyah suggested, let whoever enters the gate-like pathway to Kaaba be the one to place the stone. So just forget it and get on with the solution. They finally agreed to this and eagerly waited for the next person to come through this gate. Subhanallah, and what do you know? Who walks in? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam walked right through. The entire city was so relieved and cheered happily. He was well known to be honest always and a truthful person. What a great character had just walked through. Everybody was happy and no war needed anymore. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was told about this decision so he could place the stone as agreed by everyone and the matter would be over. But look at Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He on the spur of the moment comes up with giving honor to all. That is, by sharing his honor. This was truly a leadership quality. Thinking for others too, not just for himself. He asked for a sheet, placed the stone in its center, asked all the four chiefs to hold up the sheet and carry it to the Kaaba corner. Here he, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, picked the stone up and placed it there firmly. Alhamdulillah, that was a happy ending, and no lives were lost over this issue. So our learning outcome could be, I think, I learned a big lesson from this event. Make big problems small in size and share honor with those around us. So let's begin by doing that with our family. With this, we come to the end of our story today. Till next time, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.